New World proudly brings you coverage of tonight's match. We love netball as much as you do.
No, I think the Steel fans will pull through. No sweat.
Yeah, I think they really need to step it up to impress their fans.
Whether they lost momentum, I don't know, but I was terribly disappointed.
Probably maybe put some of the more experienced players on right from the word go.
Well, just keep the faith, yeah.
Between England and the Silver Ferns, and tonight is the decider. Good evening, glad you could join us. Well, tonight the Silver Ferns are on the comeback trail. After beating England by 39 goals on Monday, they were then stunned to lose by 2 on Wednesday, and tonight losing is just not an option. They not only need to win the series, but they also need to restore some faith back with the New Zealand public. And England, well, not surprisingly, their confidence is at an all-time high.
Silver Ferns in real trouble in this second test against England. And the sort of team that'll just rise in confidence.
We were just so low after the first test. 39 goals, we really got whooped. Just to compose ourselves and come back for the second test and just leave the first test behind. I think it was a great team effort and great coaching by Sue Morgan as well.
You two keep working that pressure. They go outside that ring, jam them up, jam them up.
Oh, McClymer! Brilliant stuff again.
Yeah, you know, with Jeeva it is quite easy out there. We have a good understanding of what each other are going to do. So, you know, when she was out there, you know, at the back behind me, I knew what I had to go for, and she kind of covered my back on certain things as well, so we kind of worked nicely together.
I just feel so comfortable. I'm able to do my thing, and I know that we kind of work perfectly together. Right from when we first started playing, we didn't have to call each other much. We just reacted off each other, and we've always got each other's back. So,
well, this is an incredible turnaround by England. 39 goals in the first test, and looking for a major upset against the Silver Ferns on their home soil.
We always turn the ball over, we've got great defenders, and we stepped up our full court defence as well, but I think it was actually what we did once we turned the ball over. We maintained possession a lot more, created a lot more options for the ball carrier, and gave our shooters a lot more opportunities.
Woo, what a difference a couple of days can make.
Well, joining us in the One Sport team again this evening is Kerry Wills. Welcome, Kerry. Kerry, how far can self-belief and confidence take this England team?
Well, nothing galvanises a team better, Tony, than to come back against seemingly all odds and take a win, which is what England did. They arrived here on Monday wanting to win. They got blown away on Monday night, and then by the end of Wednesday, they had that confidence back and that self-belief needed to win.
Massive blow losing Julie Seymour. She's out with an Achilles injury. Even if Ruth Aiken wanted to play her top tier this evening, she has no choice now.
Yeah, look, they've got to cope with those changes, but also without Julie's leadership on court. They need to put it out there. They've said it wasn't Ruth Aitken's fault. They say it's players' responsibility. Let's see it out there tonight.
Yeah, well, it's their time to step up, absolutely. Well, we'll show you the starting lineup, which I'm sure you're all keen to see in a moment, but right now we have the coin toss. The captains tonight, Laura Langman and Sonia McClymer. And it looks like England has the first centre pass, so they'll have the ball first up. It's crunch time here in Palmerston North, though. Can England back up their heroic performance on Wednesday, or will the Silver Ferns find form just in the nick of time? with no Julie Seymour tonight, Ruth Aitken's mid-court options are severely limited. She really has only two options at wing attack, Liana Barrett-Chase, who's just come into the squad, or Marie Bowden, who has only started a couple of times. What will she do? Let's take a look. With the loss of Julie Seymour, Ruth Aitken has had to rethink her attacking end this evening. Many will be happy to see Irene van Dijk is back at goal shoot, and Maria Tutaia comes off the bench to start at goal attack. No Julie Seymour means Laura Langman is forced to cover the centre position this evening, so Marie Bowden will hold on to her starting spot at wing attack, and Jolene Henry, as she's done all series, will begin at wing defence. It's all about experience down the defensive end, with Cheryl Scanlon pulled in for Katrina Grant at goal defence and Casey Williams at goal keep. Midcourt-wise, the bench is looking particularly thin, with only newcomer Liana Barrett-Chase as cover. Coach Ruth Aitken wanting her team to step it up big time tonight.
We've all got to make sure that we step up tonight. It's a big game. It's a series up for grabs. So certainly we have to put pressure on all through the court on defence. And then on attack, we have to have the confidence to let it go.
No surprises, Sue Hawkins isn't making a single change to the team that beat the Silver Ferns on Wednesday. Louisa Brownfield will don the goal shoot bib, teaming up with Pamela Cookie at goal attack. Karen Atkinson is the wise head in the midcourt at wing attack. Her combination with Jade Clark at centre just keeps getting stronger, and Ama Abwezi starts again at wing defence. But the big strength in this English side is their circle defence. Sonia McClomer at goal defence was MVP on Wednesday, and she'll pair once again with Jeeva Mentor at goal keep. None of the reserves bench got a run on Wednesday. Rachel Dunn is the most likely backup shooter. Coach Sue Hawkins confident her lineup has the goods.
You know, the feeling of winning is, I think it's foreign to some of these English girls, and they learnt how to win the other night, and I think that's a huge lesson that they'll take away from this series.
Well, it's good to see Ruth Aitken starting, Irene van Dijk back in at goal shoot, and of course Marie Bowden comes into the mix now with Julie Seymour injured.
That's right, Jenny May, big opportunity for Marie Bowden tonight, isn't it? I think it could be a make or break test match for her tonight. I think one thing that'll help her out is, as you say, with Irene van Dijk in at goal shoot and Maria Tutaia out at goal attack, it's a much more tried and true shooting circle, so I think that'll help her, and I think she combines quite nicely with Lang.
All right, now let's look at England. No surprises. Sue Hawkins has rung no changes.
Well, not surprised about that, are we? An extraordinary performance from the on-court seven that are taking the court again tonight on Wednesday night. What impressed me most about them was their finish, that they held on under that intense pressure to win. I think tonight, crucial for them, is a good start to get their confidence going again.
Well, on Wednesday night, the question was whether England could pick themselves up. That question is firmly directed at the Silver Ferns now.
Well, I'm with you, Julie. It's a big night for Marie Bowden. She's been on the cusp of the Silver Ferns for a number of years now, but tonight it's her chance to prove that she's worthy of being in that starting lineup.
Yeah, the shooters and defenders, you know, they get a lot of credit. And yes, the middies, we do all the hard work without all the glory, but, you know, you wouldn't have it any other way. I love being a midcourter, and it's lots of fun. For me, it's that you've got to just want to be there, and that you would just do your absolute best no matter what. And, you know, you're willing to do anything to be the best player that you can be. You know, everyone has got the fire in the belly, wants to play and wants to do really well.
Well, Kiri, tonight it seems like the Silver Ferns bench is particularly vulnerable. Is that a worry?
Yeah, look, most teams go with a ratio of 4-4-4, and Ruth Aitken, with her top-class defenders, has 5 defenders and 3 mid-quarters, which leaves it a bit shaky, particularly at wing attack.
Okay, we talk about vulnerability, but when we look at the shooters, it sort of shows that they're vulnerable. We're having to keep putting goal shooters into goal attack, doesn't it?
Well, look, all 4 of those shooters started their careers as goal shoots. So we've got Maria, who can play goal attack, and we're trying to force a 36-year-old goal shoot out into goal attack as well. Surely it should be one of those younger shooters who is now looking at taking that position.
Absolutely. Well, look, I've been talking to the players for a number of days now, and I can tell you they are so amped for tonight's match. They're hurting from Wednesday, and in the backs of their mind, there's a small little team called Australia.
I think it is really important for us to win for ourselves. We are going into a test series against Australia. We cannot afford to go into that test series with a low. So we need to make sure that our combinations work, our links work, and that we put the ball through the hoop. Now, we're out there representing the nation. We're out there representing our friends and family, and we need to do them justice.
It's all on here at Arena Manawatu in Palmerston North. The players are bibbed up, ready to grow. The crowd is just hushed. They're waiting for them to come out. Your commentators this evening are Jenny May Coffin and Julie Coney.
Thanks, Tony. The Ferns have regained a humiliating loss just 3 days ago in Dunedin after an extraordinary turnaround from this team here, England, on Wednesday night. 39 goals down on game one, up two in game two. This woman here had a lot to do with that victory on Wednesday night, accompanied by her in-circle defender, Jeeva Mentor. So, Julie, it's an intriguing match we've got here on our hands for this third decider. Who would have thought?
I know. I'm really excited about this match tonight. It's going to be anybody's game, and I just think that the start for both of these teams is all important.
Well, the most important thing for the Silver Ferns is that this woman here is back where she belongs in the goal shoot bit.
Nice to see her in that GS bit, isn't it? And Tutaia being more of a specialist goal attack, playing in the goal attack position, I think that'll help out.
And this is a special night too for Laura Langman. This is the first time that she has captained the Silver Ferns. Of course, she was a vice captain alongside Casey Williams with Julie Seymour in the lineup, with Julie Seymour out with an Achilles injury.
And look at the height there of Darren Chase. You know, she's dwarf, isn't she? Beside DeBrain and Casey Williams.
Yes, that young lady, 23-year-old, the Anna Barrett Chase, into the lineup due to Julie Seymour's injury. And we get ready for the national anthems, and the England anthem will be sung by Vala Kalua. First though, here's our umpires, an all-Australian affair. And the New Zealand anthem sung by the Mayor of Palmerston North, Jono Naylor.
Save the Queen. Save Ladies and gentlemen, please stand by. Get ready for the match.
Well, there's a challenge for Tim Shadbolt, Jenny May.
Yes, of course, the mayor of Palmerston North, John O'Naylor. Did a good job of the New Zealand National Anthem, and here is our ball deliverer for this evening, Dame Charlotte from Palmerston North. Big night for her.
Ladies and gentlemen, a welcome please for our new world ball deliverer.
She gets to deliver the ball to Jay Clark, England centre, who have the first set of pass off for this evening. So, Julie, on the first night I gave you the odds. The odds tonight with the matchup one apiece, New Zealand $4.75, so still the favourites, England $1.14.
Well, after England's performance on Wednesday night, I thought it might have dropped a little below that.
England quickly into their work, nice little passes. Sure, Scanlon had a hand to that one.
Well, you actually saw her clip the hand of Cookie. Brilliant. An early turnover for England.
Brilliant work there from Emma Abuzi. And England playing with a lot of speed.
Yes, talking to Sue Hawkins before the game, she said she was very impressed with their warm-up this morning, that they played with a lot of speed on attack. More defensively tonight.
Well, it looks good so far. Silver Ferns bringing that ball out of the defensive end with quite a bit of pace.
Inside.
Mrs. Williams urging her teammates on in the opening minutes of this first quarter. Abuzi
fires to no one. She's done two players there, but both had their backs to her.
She's done that all three tests. Every first touch on attack, she's thrown their first ball away, but I'm pretty sure she gets the ball back.
Top of the circle almost closed down for Langman, but she'll get the penalty.
Well, good work there from McCloma.
She's
crazy on the pass.
And she's got such a long reach, hasn't she, McCloma? And that's where she's spoiled there, just those long arms.
Unfortunately, she gives the ball back to the Silver Ferns with a step, just out of control, a little bit on attack. But there she goes again.
Yes, I think New Zealand underestimated the McCloma mentor duo, didn't they, a little in that second test. They won't be doing that tonight. They'll be wanting to move the ball short and sharp, not getting it lifted on attack, New Zealand. So they'll want to be turning the heads of the English defenders.
So Rico Kitt will be happier with that start. Nice drive away from the ball.
I think it's so important that neither of these teams gets a real lead on the other in this first quarter. Easily for confidence, self-belief. So England will not want this to get any further ahead.
Is it speed again coming out from that England attacking line?
Great tussle going on between Scanlon and Cookie. Both very low, fast, close to the ground players.
And already you see the intensity is high for the Silver Ferns in comparison to Wednesday night in this first quarter.
Total misunderstanding on attack, and New Zealand's defence impressive. Goodness me, we don't want another injury. Langman looked like she was going over on that ankle, because New Zealand had come into this test match, or into the series, with only three mid-quarters. They're heavy on defence, five defenders. So another injury in the mid-court would be disastrous.
Well, it would mean the injection of Liana Barrett-Chase, who is very much inexperienced at this level. Played at the World Tournament and was with the team that won the under-21 gold medal.
World Youth Champs.
Yes. So
Now let's just have a look at this with Casey Williams. Misunderstanding between the feeder and shooter. Casey Williams cleans it up easily.
She was in good position, wasn't she? She was where the shooter wanted to drop.
Well, we talked about Abuizi with her first touch of the ball earlier. And Marie Bowden has dished off another one of the passes to no one in this game.
With the wing, with the wing.
There she is. Call for the contact, no doubt, trying hard to get their ball back.
That through-court defence already, you can see from New Zealand, much tighter than it was in the second test.
Casey Williams just caught jumping in the air before the ball was released. Cookie with the long shot, no way, no how.
Quite a flat shot she's got, isn't it? And if she's got that flat shot, she really needs to step back and away from the defender's reach. Brownfield, she's getting stronger, isn't she, with her body. She's holding nice space.
Shortly.
This time she'll get the call. An appalling shot from Louisa Brownfield.
Yeah, they're going to have to put that one away. Silver Ferns, I would imagine, will go up 5-1.
Look at that. England only netted one of their four attempts so far. Can she do it this time, Brownfield? New Zealand sharp under the goal.
There's Clark again.
Birthday yesterday, Jade Clark, 25 years of age. Happy birthday, Jade, for yesterday.
Well, she had a wonderful game on Wednesday night. Defensive game. Nice pass from Cookie, finds Brownfield close to the post. But so far, she is having a shot.
Yeah, she's getting the ball. It's just, yes, her shooting way off. Just 1 from 4.
Oh, that pass overcooked from Van Dijk to Langman. She did well just to get it in.
And Van Dijk does a great job. She gave the ball away and some great defensive work right up to that transverse line. And that's what New Zealand coaching team are looking for as well. They want that full court defence right from their shooting end. They need to do that to slow down England's play through court.
And Cloma called for the contact. Tutahia makes the most of it. The Ferns ahead by 4 goals. Better start by the home side. And a nice drive there from Cookie.
Contact. Williams just too close, coming in on the landing. Good quick release from Bowden, but the ball was just overcooked again, wasn't it? It was going over Van Dijk's head and it gave the defence an opportunity to have a tock at it. It needed to drop in front of Van Dijk.
Nice cut there from Langman. And a nice pass from Tutahia to Van Dijk.
Van Dijk happy to be in that position, isn't she? 4 from 4.
Oh, Cookie was open on the baseline. Brownfield couldn't see her. Nice roll away from Atkinson. Great shot from Brownfield, finally.
Yeah. I think she shoots them better from distance than she does from under the goals.
Bowden having to look back.
Contact when you're called.
And a contact called on Jolene Henry. She's pushed off her line a little bit.
Good defence from England though. They're not letting the ball flow through court easily for New Zealand. They're up and over the ball.
Cookie going offside.
Just from the sideline, this game seems 3 times more intense than both the other two tests, which is great from both teams.
Nice little roll on the baseline there from Van Dijk. Oh, and Cookie again. Brownfield just not having the vision to turn and look in. Cookie had a nice cut on the baseline. Never mind though, let's see what she can do with it.
Settling into her business now, Brownfield. Can she maintain it?
Van
And that's the danger of the one-on-one. Juba Mentor just pulled behind Irene van Dijk. Straight pass from Tisaya into her shooting.
Yes, it was better, wasn't it? You know, nice flat ball. Didn't give Mentor a chance to have a go at it.
Jimmy's business, Gracie Williams.
Well, a few of these girls were embarrassed about their performance on Wednesday night. I certainly want to change that.
Well, they can go up with a five-goal lead with 5 minutes to play, but again, a pass push just a little bit too far, but that's good defence there from England.
Doing some good work on defence. Great defensive duo. We heard
wing attack.
Norma Plummer, the Australian coach, I heard her on radio yesterday, and she was saying that she believes that this defensive pairing for England are the best defensive pairing at international netball. I'd have to concur with her. They're pretty tidy.
Nice work there from Atkinson. Speed and agility. Brownfield intimidated by that jump from Casey Williams.
Hell ball. There she is, Norma Plummer. Australian coach, of course. New Zealand will meet Australia for two tests, one next weekend and one the weekend after.
And unfortunately, the Silver Ferns have turned their ball over again, allowing England just to creep back closer. Within three now. Nice quick passing between Bowden and Langman.
Again, quick hands from Mentor spoiled that.
No, Jackie Jashari. Not sure what she called there.
The call was possession for Jade Clark on the outside of the circle. Her and Laura were having a bit of a, Laura Langman were having a bit of a tussle. Oh, yes, because Mentor got a tip to it and it flew back out. And
step forward, goal defence, right there.
The two outside fighting for possession.
Well, whatever the reason, England have capitalised on it. They come within two of the Silver Ferns with just under 4 minutes to play here at Arena Manawatū.
Take it back to the centre. Bib for the bib.
Just a bit of timeout.
Back to the centre. That is great goal defence.
Again, England started quite strong through that midcourt with their defensive intercepts. Jade Clark, she was damaging in the second test. Again, getting good intercept ball. She's very quick.
That was a good shot from where we were. That did not knock out of court. But the umpire has called it out of court. On the line is still in court. So, interesting call there.
That is contact.
Yes, lines are part of the court.
Van Dijk dodging.
Yeah, Mentor doing a good job, isn't she?
Yeah.
Lovely long shot from Tutaia. And that's what's great when Van Dijk's under the pressure. Tutaia will put that long shot up.
And the other thing is Tutaia knows that Van Dijk will be there for the rebound, so she can put those long shots up. From Mentor, tipping the shot.
And she's done outstanding work, Mentor, since she's come back in. She had a really bad ankle injury, and to play that whole match on Wednesday night, just off the injury.
Holding keeper, back there, right back.
You wouldn't even know she's been injured. She's that agile around the court. Yes, you noticed it a little on Wednesday night. She was sort of favouring it at times, but not tonight.
That's a sweet shot from Brownfield. Nothing but net. So the Silver Ferns had an opportunity to pull away by 5 goals, but England have managed to get it closer. What a brilliant intercept there from Laura Langman.
The only difference really is the shooting stats from these two teams. They've both put up 12 attempts at goal. New Zealand 83%, England 67. There it is. Irene van Dijk without a miss.
And again, Mentor just pulled behind Van Dijk. Bowden has to look back to Henry, back to Bowden. Bowden finds the circle edge, which is exactly where your feeders want to be. Tutaia with the long shot.
Sensational, isn't she, Maria? She's doing a lot of work around the court and then finishes off with shots like that.
Yes, there was some talk that she had to play in the goal shoot position to settle herself into the game, but she's got the confidence now, hasn't she? And she settles beautifully at goal attack.
So a bit of a timeout here. Jade Clark, the centre for England, has called time for a hand injury.
Pretty common in netball.
So still a few turnovers in this first quarter, Julie, but the intensity is certainly there.
Yes, it's a lot more how you would expect the competition between these two teams, isn't it? The, you know, the first test match, England's so disappointing.
What do we put that down to? That was just...
It was a shocker, wasn't it? An absolute shocker. I think the combinations that were put on court that night, there were a lot of combinations being tried. And they were without mentor, they just didn't. And New Zealand got on top early and it was good night nurse. And here's the replay, just to see if we can catch what happens to Jade's hand.
Yeah, Langman just talking it on the way through. No problem though for Clark. Emma Abuizi having a good solid
step
game
step
tonight.
Just there, body fans. Yes.
So McClymer with the restart. Back to Clark. Cookie.
Great work from Scanlon.
Waited for the 2.5 seconds before she went to jump on the shot.
Yep, she didn't go for the fake either. Cookie put a little fake in there and she stayed on the ground. Good work.
That's obviously what they've been working on. You hear the outside defenders also saying to her to wait, wait.
Yes, it's like putting a bit of super glue on those shoes until the third second.
Well, they've obviously looked at the shooters and looked at the timing of their shot and the release of the shot.
Yes, yes.
And as we said before, Cookie's shot is quite flat.
So the Silver Ferns will be fairly happy with this start to the match.
Two shooters in, McClymer called out of the circle.
Van Dijk with the long shot, haven't seen one of these from her for a while.
How's it? No, that's the furthest shot that she's taken from the goal.
So at the end of the first quarter, the Silver Ferns are ahead by 6 goals over England, 14-8. Coverage of the New World International Series between the Silver Ferns and England. It is game three. It is all on. New Zealand currently ahead of England by 6 goals in this first quarter. So it was interesting listening to both coaches at the quarter break. What Sue Hawkins would have wanted to see.
Certainly what she wasn't asking, no.
No, not when they're looking at 7 goals down. Scanlon finds Tutaia.
What's letting England down is look at that off their centre pass off. They're just turning over a little too much ball there. New Zealand's been quite clinical off their possession, but England, and that was England's centre pass off that they lost that one from.
So that was nice work between Tutaia and Van Dijk.
And with New Zealand 6 goals out, they really must maintain possession, England.
Oh, it doesn't get much better than that from a shooter in England.
Again, send a pass off, lost possession.
Yep, Atkinson unable to hold on to that one. Williams finds Henry. Bowden.
Those contact centre.
It's a passing cut off Tutaia.
Some good work from Bowden to get herself onto the edge of the circle. She's getting there nicely.
Obstruction. That's it.
Tutaia just slipped back slightly from that long reach. Slots it.
Van Dijk untangling herself there from mentor.
Tutaia with a long shot.
Yes, they like it when Irene van Dijk moves, don't they? And she gets to the edge of the circle and they block and hold her out there.
England just struggling to get the ball through the mid-court. Cookie coming out, so is Brownfield.
Oh, and again, valuable possession turned over.
What a disastrous second quarter this is for England in the opening 3 minutes.
Yes, they really had to stay with New Zealand, didn't they? Especially being six down going into this quarter.
That was a nice fake from Bowden to find Langman. Ball swings wide. Good work there from England.
And you see, they like this. Van Dijk's out, and they're holding her at the top. She works her way under now. But that's the one thing Ruth Aiken did ask at the quarter break. Don't want you out too much, Irene. You know, if necessary, come late.
So England, after being within three of the Ferns, now staring down the barrel of an 11-goal deficit.
That is contact centre.
See if Cookie can narrow the gap.
Still not on the board in this quarter, England.
Big pass from Langman to find Bowden. And a nice little pop pass from Tutaia once again.
Van Dijk not wanting to put up that long shot. Hoping to move it a bit closer. Good safe pass from Langman. There was the temptation there perhaps to pop it over to Van Dijk, but with tall defenders, can't afford to do that.
What you get with Van Dijk underneath the post, she's going to get every single rebound.
I was going to say, when are they going to call time, this English team? New Zealand had such a run on them.
Yes,
somebody had to call time.
Captain Sonia McCloma puts her hand up and says, I'll do it. Not to say to the folks at home that she may not be injured, but... She's not.
No. So, a bit of a tactical move.
Look, it has been a disastrous quarter for the England side, hasn't it, so far?
Yeah, poor old Louisa Brownfield's not having a good night tonight. She's dropped the ball and replayed it. She's fallen out of court and she's had some shocking shots. She'll be wanting to pick herself up for the next part of this game.
Well, the Silver Ferns have scored six goals so far. England, zero.
Yeah, just sloppy turnovers, you know, and out of a couple of balls out of court. Lois Miai there. Not a test match without her, is it?
No, that's right. I'm surprised she hasn't got a book with her. Usually she's scribbling down notes. Maybe she's over that now. All right, so the Silver Ferns get this game underway. Tutaia.
Lovely movement from Langman.
Well, it's just good how Bowden went wide and allowed Tutaia to come through the top of the circle.
Yeah, the little passing cut made herself available. And again, off England centre pass off. Great pressure from New Zealand. Turn the ball over.
Can it get any worse?
Well, I'll be wanting this quarter to be over and done with fairly quickly.
Well, they took the time out to try and slow down the Silver Ferns' momentum.
Mental's just getting called at this end of the court as well by the umpire for coming within distance. She's got to get a bit more discipline and just take an extra step back.
And great work there, great timing from both Van Dijk and Langman.
Again, you see, mentor pulled.
Bring it down over here.
Nines it in this quarter.
So there's Langman with her first cap as Silver Ferns captain. Special night for her. She'll want to make it an even more memorable night with a win over that England side. And it isn't going to happen if you're going to throw passes like that over Casey Williams.
Yeah, it was some great defence work inside. And they had the shooters well and truly covered. They really, England really needed to bring the ball back and reset instead of forcing it in over Casey Williams.
over the top of that young lady. Good drive from Langman.
Smooth as you like from Tutahia.
Oh, can England hold on to the ball? Cookie out the top finds Atkinson. Oh,
no, they can't, Jenny May.
Oh, look, Atkinson just put too much on the end of that ball. Silver Ferns will take full advantage of this. Tutahia way outside too is Van Dijk.
So they bring it back and reset it. Good thinking, good patience.
Now Boise called for the contact. So let's see what England can do with this. And again, there's Brownfield just offering a way pass.
They try and swing that ball across the circle. It is not going to work. It needs to be more of a triangle or somebody playing at the top of the circle, but they play quite wide at times. And that's exactly what the defence are looking for.
Okay, clever work there from Langman. She was on the ground. Can't play the ball off the ground. She gets herself back up and puts a nice little pass into Van Dijk, who's on the baseline.
We're out of play now. No talking. Thanks.
Halfway through this second quarter and England are still not on the board in this quarter.
Well, after promising so much in that first quarter, it's a shambles really in the second quarter for England.
Just there.
Everything they do is either a contact or a ball going astray.
A lot more pressure being put on, as it was in the first test, by the New Zealand defence. Look at this. Really covering the middle of the court, England having to play wide. That was better, bringing it into the middle at the top of the circle rather than swinging it, trying to swing it right across. But again, they're not going to get it on the board again.
No, Cookie called for the contact. Well, we talked about the Silver Ferns having that embarrassing loss on Wednesday night.
They're certainly fired up tonight. There's a lot of pressure at halftime with Waitemanu. This defensive trio of Casey Williams, Cheryl Scanlon and Jolene Henry were just all eyes on Wai. I don't know what she was saying, but they were pretty much enthralled.
Well, Langman needs to thank Bowden for this ball. There was a hope pass that went way over the top and Lafayma got an arm to it.
Arms before, yes.
Well, this really is a commanding performance from the Silver Ferns, isn't it? 20 goals they need, England, after 25 minutes of play.
Irene van Dijk hasn't missed a shot yet. 18 from 18 for her.
About it, looking, finds Langman at the top there.
But there it goes, lovely, good work. Nice patience from Langman outside, and a good turn of the body from Van Dijk. She's happy with it.
England with the centre pass, let's see if they can get it into that circle and do something with it. Brownfield, I'm not going to put that one up from out wide. Good work from Clark, teetering on the edge there. Let's see if Brownfield can deal with it.
On the board in the second quarter, finally, England, with just almost 5 minutes left to play in the second quarter.
Well, England have called time out, and we see Cookie leaving the court. And it looks like Rachel Dunn is going to be injected into the match at goal shoot. The Brownfield being put out to goal attack. Sure whether that was a planned move from England. The thing's not going so well out on court. So Rachel Dunn onto the court for England. see what she can do and help inject something into this England side. Nice pass there from Bowden. Good pick up too from Van Dijk. To Dahia from out wide. And again.
Yes, I'm not sure what Cookie finished her shooting percentage on. She was only 2 from 4 at the break.
And the train wreck continues for England. Another turnover.
Also, interestingly, Binns was running along the sideline trying to get on the court as well, but was too late in that change. So maybe seeing a mid-court change later on in this quarter or at the end of it anyway.
Good clean up from Bowden. But it's turned back over by the Silver Ferns. England looking for just their second goal in this quarter. It's going to take a little while, I think.
Yes, I think Cookie probably finished about 2 from 4. That's what happened in the first test. She actually didn't put any shots, or she didn't get any shots in the second or the third quarter when she was on court in that first test. So Sue Hawkins very quick to make that change when she wasn't making an impact and putting shots up.
Good tip there from Mentor. The most pleasing aspect for me so far in this match is to see someone like Marie Bowden, who had an under par performance on Wednesday night. She's come back into this match and really stamped her authority on it. And perhaps we may see some changes rung at the half break with the score at 32 points tonight.
Well, I'd really like to see Paula Griffin given a go tonight. If New Zealand are far enough ahead, it would be great to see her, because I'm not sure that they will perhaps look at her against Australia. So this is the opportune time to do it. But not too much change with it, you know, just a subtle change.
Good tip there from Shel Scanlon.
From the sideline, I can tell you that with 2 minutes 40 to go, there's not a lot of movement. Danica Wafiti is on the bike. Whether that says something about the changes that may or may not happen, who knows?
Thanks for that, Curry. Silver Ferns with the ball back in hand. Henry lucky to get that ball away and find one of her teammates. Bowden searching, has to go back again. Irene van Dijk running around quite a bit.
Yeah, the call from Ruth was stand there, Irene. So
that's it.
Maybe they're stationary.
Maybe she's done a bit too much running. We might see young Danica Wafiti come into the game. But why wouldn't you, at the score, do it 33 points to 9?
Great opportunity to do it.
Both players
establish the lead, get the confidence, get the heads of the English down, their tails between their legs, and then make the change. And that's what we were saying earlier, that the start was all important in this match. And it's New Zealand that have come out on top. Well and truly. It's incredible just how performances, how much they can swing.
Wing defence contact and offside advantage. Outside.
Henry called for the contact on the outside. Well, no, offside. No, it is a contact on the outside of the circle. Good defence there from the Silver Ferns. So, can Dunn stop the drought? No, let's see what Brownfield can do.
It's the first time I've seen 20 goals in a quarter in a long time in a match.
Two things at play here.
I can see why that caught a smile to Ruth Aiken's face. It's pretty to watch, isn't it? Beautiful shot. Maria Tutaia.
Yeah, two things at play here. The Silver Ferns really were disappointed.
Another set of pass off Jenny May, sorry. Just England letting possession go.
Contact keeper with you, shooter.
Yes, it really is an awful performance in the second quarter.
Contact
from England.
Defense, you're both out.
But the intensity from New Zealand lifted.
That's it.
Yep. I don't know, yes. 10, 20 notches from
Wednesday
night.
Absolutely. That combined with England's disarray in this second quarter has certainly contributed to this scoreline. Let's see if Van Dijk can finish it off. No, she doesn't. But does it really matter? I'm not sure that it does. New Zealand are ahead of England by 26 goals.
the Silver Ferns lead England here in Palmerston North at halftime. A big reason why the score is so large is because England conceded 15 unanswered goals in the second quarter. I think that's pretty unheard of, and I would imagine, Julie Coney, it doesn't look very pretty on the stats board either.
No, not a pretty picture for England at all. New Zealand there at the top have put up 33 more attempts at goal to that of England. And look at New Zealand shooting stats, 90%. Irene van Dijk, I can tell you, has not missed a shot yet. That's why we like her at goal shoot. And look at the turnover score. England, too many turnovers and only scoring of 8 of their 23 centre pass-offs. Just giving possession away under a lot of pressure from New Zealand.
Well, let's take a look at Silver Fern goalkeeper, Casey Williams. Now, she's had 3 intercepts so far in the first half of this match. Now, I would say that she had a below par performance on Wednesday night, but she's come out firing in tonight's decider. Vice captain, there she goes. Having another blinder tonight. Let's take a look at Karen Atkinson, the 30-year-old. Athletic co-captain, starting the match well. Slick passing and decisive movements. Also picked up 1 intercept, but really has failed to fire in the second 15. Not as much presence in this match. Perhaps you can put that down to the defensive effort of 1 Jolene Henry.
McComber and Mentor, they were the stars in game 2. Tonight, where are they?
Well, look, it is a commanding performance from our shooters. We've already talked about Irene, but Maria Tutaia is having a blinder as well. We've got people in the crowd with signs saying Irene for goal shoot. So they're living up to their experience and the expectations of the public, and it makes it easier for Marie Bowden at wing attack to come in as the new player.
Absolutely. I mean, that attacking end is certainly working a lot better. England, though, throwing away an awful amount of possession, 15 unanswered goals. How do they let that happen?
Yeah, there's a little bit of flakiness about that. Those shooters from England. Louisa Brownfield's dropped ball. She's gone out, caught the ball out of court, and she's missed some crucial shots. And Pamela Cookie's had to be dragged off midway through the quarter. We hope to see them improve in the next quarter so that it makes the game a lot more interesting and possibly see some changes to the New Zealand lineup.
Who's been the star for you so far?
So far, I have liked Maria Tutaia. She's just sublime with her shooting. She does a lot of work off the line. She's just solid, and that's where we like her, and that's where we like Irene.
She'll be certainly relishing the chance to have a start tonight, Maria Tutaia. Stay with us. It's halftime here in Palmerston North. After the break, we're into third quarter.
Get it, girl. To the front, to the side, to the back, but don't let him ride. Keep going, girl, it's your night. Don't let him steal your lie. I know he thinks you're fine and stuff, but does he know how to wind you up?
Come on.
See you back for more action after the break.
To the second half action, and if you've just joined us, New Zealand are in a commanding position, 36 goals to England's 10. And no surprises, Julie, that we see a few changes for the English side.
Thank you to the big girls, and thank you also to New World.
Yes, it looks like Jake Clark going into the wing defence position, and Aboisi going into centre.
Well,
I know that she's been played on a little bit of a change. It looks like she's going to wing attack.
No, here we go. We've got Joanna Binns coming on at wing attack, and Karen Atkinson moving into the centre position with Jade Clark moving back to wing defence.
Now we've got it. I was going to say, Aboisi in the attack position, I don't think so.
And as you may have expected, the Silver Ferns haven't made any changes. Ruth Aitken opting to stay with her starting 7.
wanting to solidify this lead even more. Let's see what England can do to dig themselves out of this hole. Bins finds Atkinson. See if Dunn can put this away. Well, a good start early on in the third quarter for England. Langman with the ball. Tutaya looking to cut the top of the circle, but forced to take the shot wide. She shrugged just saw her shoulders a little bit on that one.
Yes, move back. Keep one more step back. Yes, thank you. Those players,
so the Silver Ferns with...
Just step back, you know, around in front where you were.
Really?
Yes, there.
A commanding second quarter, scoring 22 goals. England managing just...
Yes, the shooting circle was changed with 5 minutes to go in the second quarter. Cookie had only put up one attempt at goal in that second quarter and missed it. And Sue Hawkins rung the changes, brought Dunn on in the circle with Brownfield going out.
Well, it was Dunn's second shot for the quarter. No good. Nice clearing pass from Scanlon.
Oh, beautiful. Two passes down the court. And that's great. That's what they didn't do in the second test, the defence. They didn't bring that ball through court strongly. And
well, it was great confidence shown by both defenders to be able to turn and to let the ball go.
Yep.
But I guess when you're this far ahead, you don't mind if a couple go astray. You just give it a go.
That's right. She had a quick, fast break, Jolene Henry. Have a look at it on the replay.
Yeah, take a look at that big pass from Scanlon through the midcourt, and Henry looking to her magic teammate.
Scrum-Dyke had a good hold, didn't she, at the top of the circle. Plenty of room to drop back into the space as long as she held the move. And again, Tutaia with the long shot.
Nothing but net on that one.
76%, 13 from 17, but... I can tell you all of the shots have been taken from well outside. There's only one that I can see on a little graphic that she's taken within the 2 metre mark. So they're all from distance, folks.
Well, and not able to convert the turnover that Jolene Henry caused. And there she goes again.
Beautiful and set.
She's back home, you know. She's a Whanganui girl. So... she's back where it all began for her, and she's putting on a performance for the home crowd.
You'd have to say that Jolene Henry has really grown into this black dress, hasn't she, in this series. We've seen her, she got player of the match in the first series. She had probably one of the better performances out of the New Zealand team. There she goes, look at that. Does it with style, doesn't go offside, flicks the ball back in. Seemed like she had all the time in the world.
I think the other thing with Henry is the fact that she's been given the opportunity to play in consecutive matches for the Silver Ferns. In previous times, she's been put on and then taken off and hasn't really been given any consistency. And there she goes again.
Sprawled again. That was her tidied up by her teammate.
And not only devastating on defence, but certainly accurate on attack.
Yeah, there's not many through-court plays that Jolene doesn't touch the ball on. She's pretty active in the attack as well as the defence. It just goes to show there's no answer, is there, under the circle when Irene Van Dyke's got a good hold, you know, puts the defence on her back, you can get the ball to her. And she puts it away. Hasn't missed a shot yet, Irene Van Dyke. Is she going to get the perfect match tonight? 27 from 27 at the moment.
Oh, and that was... not her best work. Looking to force that one into Tutaia. Well, this really is a good old-fashioned hiding.
Marie Bowden seems a lot more settled in the wing attack position tonight, doesn't she, with it? It's a shooting circle the way it is.
Absolutely. The other night, Irene Van Dyke had a goal attack, and you've got an inexperienced wing attack. It makes her job a heck of a lot tougher. Nice dish off there from Brownfield to find Dunn, who converts it for England's second goal in this match.
Quarter.
Squeeze quarter. Yes. We've got more than two. Not many, though. Not many more than two, Jenny May.
Great timing attack.
That's it.
Goal defence, you're holding a hand.
I'm not sure whether you heard the umpire there, but she said to McCloma that she's holding the hand of the Silver Fern shooter.
Belden. Van Dijk way out of the circle.
Centre, you're pausing at the top.
Mentor and McCloma have been heavily penalised in this match for their contacts.
And then just getting sucked right into Tutaia, who was coming out. No one home except Irene Van Dijk.
You see the penalties there. England double that of New Zealand. And those contacts for England, as I say, 26 of those were McClymer and Mentor in the circle.
That was better work from England throwing that diagonal pass over Cheryl Scanlon rather than Casey Williams, who's picked every single one of those off.
Contact, advantage offside wing.
So the new girl on the court, Joanna Binns. For England.
Wing attack, you're out of play. Contact.
Hasn't managed to make an impact, but that is quite tough.
And just going back to the turnovers, you know, like New Zealand's contact been so much tidier. Cordon. If we, 16 turnovers in this match for New Zealand, so they've given away 16 balls. They've turned it over 16 times. They turned it over in total in the first match 26 times, but 40 odd in the second test. So it just shows their performance much more clinical.
Big ball finds Atkinson, who finds Casey Williams. She wants a piece of the action now.
Vani's contact, goal attack! The Vani's contact, centre!
Hingman, Van Dijk again, way out.
Centre contact, Vani's offside.
Bowden finds herself stuck in the corner there. Nice lifted pass there from Langman.
Julie Seymour. Sideline tonight through an injury she sustained at a training last evening to her Achilles, and they won't really know until she's had a good scan how much damage has been done. But thought she might have been okay to play today, but couldn't get out of more than a jog. So it opened the door for Marie Boughton, who's you'd have to say had a good showing this evening.
Yes, and
they've changed defence against her, so.
Always a good sign when you're playing wing attack and you have a new opponent, means you're doing your job.
I wonder whether the change though was to counteract this lady, Laura Langman. She's been strong in the mid again for New Zealand.
And I have to say, I am enjoying seeing her back at centre, even though she does a jolly good job at wing attack. Good defense here by England. See what Tutai can do with it. What defense. Here we see a positional change between the shooters. Irene Van Dijk coming out with Maria Tutai slotting back into that shooting position.
Free pass in the circle. Yes, there. Yes.
Tutai, yeah.
Contact, wing defence, penalty.
Searching.
Look at the little pop-up here for Maria Tutai. And only one of those really taken within that 2 metre range. They're all well from distance, aren't they?
But it is interesting to see how many, you know, crosses she's got there. Because of those long shots, those are the ones you remember.
There's a few weak crosses creeping in, isn't there, for her, but
that was a gift for Casey Williams-Clark.
As long as she's got Irene Van Dijk under for the rebound.
Bullet pass from Van Dijk, and she gets it back from Langman.
And you know, we missed that understanding between Laura Langman and Irene Van Dijk in that second test. Laura not even being on the court and Irene out at goal attack.
Oh, yeah, head down there with Tutaia. To Langman was looking for the same pass. She delivered to Van Dijk.
Oh, wing defense. Just there, where she is, where you are now.
Yes, so McClymer with the ball. Passes off to Binns. Brownfield with the shot. Nice lean from Casey Williams, but it doesn't matter.
Brownfield's a new person this quarter. Good to see. Not so many errors.
Oh, fantastic. I love how she goes. Almost, you know, she's almost flying through the air, isn't she? But she still gets two hands to the ball, Casey how Williams. Incredible was that take.
She's almost horizontal, isn't she, when she goes for the ball and she gets two hands to it.
Now I'd say she would have been feeling a little sick in the stomach after Wednesday night's match, as I would imagine all the players who took the court that night. But that was absolutely sensational. Look at this. She goes for it, turns herself around and flicks it back off. Never mind the sign. Brilliant work. Good control shown by the 23-year-old.
It's not really horizontal, was it? But she gets those knees up so high that she's just this little flying bundle through the air.
Now, I'm telling you, there is no other international defender that takes ball like Casey Williams. Laura Langman.
She's now doing the damage as well. She's taken three clean intercepts herself, Laura Langman.
Like I say, she looks good in that centre bit.
And she's doing a good job as captain too. You know, when Casey took that intercept, she turned around and gave her the thumbs up and, you know, encouragement, good work.
Well, we've all known that she has certainly been a leader in the making, young Laura Langman, and tonight she's shown exactly why, staying composed, coming into this test match. Tutaia, not this time. So Dunn coming out of the circle as well.
Right. The way the score line's going at the moment, we're heading to a bigger score than we saw in the first test. Well, bigger margin.
Oh, this is just an absolute thumping. Bowden on the run. We've got to see some changes from the Silver Ferns, surely, at the end of this quarter.
Yes, you would expect that to happen.
Ooh, Langman gets a hand to the ball.
Instruction, right there.
Williams too close. So England. The score so far in this quarter, 12 to the Silver Ferns, just 5 to England. Henry,
it's just hard to put your finger on it, isn't it? How a team can fluctuate in form so much.
Well, good work from mentor.
I mean, a lot of it does have to do with the opposition that you've got out there against you, that, you know, the different lineup against. But just to drop your bundle again by so much.
Nice shot there from Brownfield.
Hold time, please.
After an absolutely extraordinary turnaround in the second test.
Another timeout with Bibbs. And Irene van Dijk is right up at the transverse line, yelling at her teammates. And it just keeps getting worse.
It's just nothing going right for them, is it? This is another of England's centre pass-offs in black hands.
They've all got shovels and they're all digging. Big pass from...
Just growing in confidence, aren't they, the Silver Ferns?
Yes. Irene, too.
Irene van Dijk's making Jeeva Mentor look like a rookie back there. She's just killing her. She has still not missed a shot either, Irene van Dijk. 35 from 35.
And again, another turnover. Clark called for the step. Let's see what Tutaia does with it.
Contact.
And it will be half a ton for the Silver Ferns at the end of this third quarter.
But Dyke will put this up.
She'll get another go. Mentor too close this time. So the time is up, but it's a penalty, so she takes the shot and we'll be going to the break.
So there we go. At the end of the third quarter, the Silver Ferns are giving England a good old thumping of 50 goals to 16.
Super silver competition from over 130,000 entries, six contestants.
Quarter time here in Palmerston North. The Silver Ferns lead England 50-16. Curry, any changes on the New Zealand bench there?
Well, it's good to see Paula Griffin after so long training with this team is out at goal attack. And Liana Debrain, good to see a veteran back out on court in goal defence. For England, we have Bayman at wing defence. Cookie has gone to wing attack.
Well, I must say that is a welcome sight for me seeing Paula Griffin on the court for the Silver Ferns. It has been a long time coming for the youngster. And Debrain with her first touch of the match.
Yes, well, subtle changes, aren't they, at both ends of the court. So not a whole work, so keeping the consistency around in support of these new players that have taken the court.
Shootout contact.
Yeah, nice work there from Mentor. Trying to inject something into this match. Atkinson.
In defense, you're grabbing around. There. Yes.
So McCloma passes off to Cookie, who's back on court and wing attack.
Griffin, of course, has played a lot of her netball at goal shoot as well, so plays both goal shoot and goal attack. Done. Happier on that shot. Casey Williams just about, but not quite. And England.
England
back in possession, but just not putting it away.
Hold time.
Where it began, I can't begin to know.
So Williams just calling a bit of time out there. Let's take a look at some of her work, though. Early in this third quarter, looks for the intercept. Just couldn't hold on to it,
well,
though.
It was those knees that, you know, I said before, she got away. Yes, she brings the legs quite high, and that's just where the ball happened to be coming to her. And then England regather possession, but mucked around with it. They're still in possession of the ball, England, and will be when we resume play.
Kimberly Cookie came back in a disastrous first game.
Yes, that's right.
3 from 10, came back in the second, picked her confidence up, but back off in this third match, really found it tough going against Cheryl Scanlon.
Yeah, Scanlon did a really good job, I felt, in the first three quarters of the match.
Oh, brilliant work there from Debrain, but she couldn't hold on to the ball. Oh, contact called on Dunn. She's appealing to the umpire. Don't want to hear about it, says Jackie Jashari.
And then she takes out Casey Williams.
A bit of frustration showing there. So Griffin with her first shot. No, she's going to dish it off, but not quite into the space. Nerves showing, perhaps. She could have taken that. That's an easy shot for Griffin.
Yes, it's a hard way to learn, but she's learning it. It's the second pass that hasn't quite had enough on it.
Oh, and just some good work spoiled there at the end by Dunn, who's unable to hold on to the ball.
Silver Ferns quickly into their work down their attack end.
It's just been a nightmare for them, hasn't it? They've just lost so much ball.
And Griffin just caught standing. Mentor coming through. It's Griffin. It's
contact keeper.
Just has to drop the pass a little bit more in front of Van Dijk.
Solid keeper with a shooter. Just there.
That's your father. But Argy Bargin's
typical there.
Yeah, she's not taking a step backwards, Paula Griffin. That's good to see. No, neither will McClymer either. Look at them. McClymer won't be happy that a rookie's been put on the court against her.
Offside centre. Inside.
Griffin. It's a long shot. So good to see Griffin get that shot under her belt, and it was a long shot.
England hanging in this final quarter at this stage.
Henry looking for someone to come through the middle. Griffin perhaps caught just a little bit deep.
Irene van Dijk still going for the perfect match. 38 from 38 at the moment.
Finding it difficult to get away from McClymer.
Two from two, so when she's had the ball to the hoop, she's been solid, Paula Griffin.
And the Manawatu crowd like it. They know their netball down here. They have so much of it in the Manawatu. And they liked it when Paula got that shot. And they've been called for the contact. Sue Hawkins.
Keep coming.
How disappointed will she be?
You know, in the second match, it was very, very difficult to pick a Silver Fern as a player of the match. Tonight, I could pick just about all of them. They've all paid well.
Yeah, they certainly have.
Again, as they did in the first test.
So England staying with the Silver Ferns in this quarter. New Zealand scoring just four, England three. Bowden and Bayman. Nice little cutback there from Paula Griffin, and she finds Van Dijk. There's a reason that lady has a goal shoot bib on.
Yes, there she is, 100%, 39 from 39, Irene van Dijk. But look at the number of goals New Zealand has put up, more than that of England. Over double, 63 to 31 attempts.
A loose pass there from Langman. Bowden unable to pick it up. Bayman.
So England just not getting their ball to their shooters, and there's no way they're going to get it.
Well, unless you can have
passes like that.
Unless you can have a little giggle about it. It's not much else you could do, really, could you, after a pass like that? So Silver Ferns attack line just slowing up a little with Griffin coming into the mix. Just a bit different timing to Tutaia.
Yes, had the right idea, didn't she? She had a nice cut, nice roll. Mentor just spoiled.
Manage offside centre.
Griffin. This is a comfortable shot for her. 20-year-old. Likes those wide shots. Going great guns at the moment. Three from three. Langman looking for Van Dijk.
Yes, and it'll take the defence a while just to pick up on her, her change as well, her different style of play.
Van Dijk asking for the ball up and over, but Juva Mentor is onto that.
Yeah, she's equal to the task when the ball's in the air, isn't she?
Griffin for number four. Nails it.
So both Bowden and Griffin, who haven't had a lot of court time for the Silver Ferns, good performances in the time they've been on court tonight. I think Bowden, you know, we talked about it earlier. This could be make or break for her in the Silver Ferns. I would have to say that she's had a good, solid performance, Jenny May. What do you think as a wing attack?
Yeah, look, I think she has played well tonight. And she probably was spurred on by the fact that Liana Barrett-Chase was brought into the side as a replacement for Judy
Somebody
Seymour.
Somebody breathing down your neck.
So you certainly want to show the coaches what you're worth. And she's, I believe, has done enough tonight. But...
yes, it'll be interesting to see what Ruth Aiken does when they go across to Australia, whether she sticks with just three mid-quarters and the five defence, or whether she changes the mix and takes four defence and four mid-court.
Well, I mean, she was shown short tonight.
And in that case, one of the defenders is going to miss out, either a Scanlon, a DeGrain.
McCroma. Really feeling this 38-goal deficit. Not giving an inch. Done way out of the circle. Finds Brownfield on the baseline. And she puts it away. Nice shot from Brownfield.
Yeah, or a Katrina Grant, just going back to the defence thing. So,
with the centre! With the centre, yes.
So switch in the defensive end. McCloma going back on Van Dijk.
Van Dijk side win. Obstruction.
Again, McCloma too close. Disrupting the shot.
That's obstruction.
She's got a few right choice there. Words to say to the umpire there.
Yes, well, we heard Sue Hawkins in the break at the three-quarter time suggesting that Mentor could come out of it and McCloma drop back in without making the positional change.
I think she actually wanted to make the positional change, but Juva Mentor said no because of her ankle injury.
Fair comment.
Well, England again coughing up the ball with an unbelievable stray pass. Griffin on the baseline. Easy shot. Nope.
First miss for Griffin. She's been solid.
Brownfield looking, finds McCloma, he finds Atkinson. Dunn having to come all the way out to be available. Good defense here, and Jolene Henry steals it. Yes, she does. Henry's fourth intercept for the night. Griffin trying to get herself a little bit closer.
Does well. She likes packing that defender back, doesn't she? She likes, you know, using her body, keeping the defence behind her.
Mentor just cannot believe that she was called for the contact when Griffin stepped in.
She's had a great game.
Yeah, she sure has. Carrying the responsibility of captaining the side tonight when they've come off an embarrassing loss in Dunedin. Good work there from De Bruyn.
And the fact that she's, you know, had to work new players in around her. Marie Bowden.
And we must also remember she is just 22 years of age.
Great jump. Good timing from Williams, but equally good shot from Brownfield. She's been holding them in at that shooting end, Louisa Brownfield. Started the game at goal shoot, moved out to goal attack when Cookie went off the boil in that second quarter.
And nice work there. Both defenders caught on Van Dijk. Paula Griffin finds herself underneath the post.
And great pass again from Langman to put her into the space. Closer to the post as she could possibly get her.
We're looking at a record score, folks. I can tell you the biggest win for New Zealand over England has been by 48 goals. It is sitting on 48 goals now on the scoreboard.
Well, on Wednesday night, the Ferns were embarrassed by their loss to England. There's a lot of red faces.
No, my maths is wrong. I'm terrible at maths. Look at that. It's actually 38.
Yes, you're right. There's 38. So another ball goes astray for England. Look, for the Silver Ferns, beg your pardon. I'm just getting in on the act, Jules. Big pass from Brownfield across to Cookie.
Well, maybe there will be one record. We might see 100% from Irene van Dijk. Just a minute 35 to go. She's sitting on 41 from 41.
Do you think Dunn's upset about that?
Yeah, the Ferns have beaten England into frustration, haven't they?
Windy fans. Right there.
Here's Griffin. Long shot. Beautiful shot from Paula Griffin. So the Silver Ferns, well and truly in command of this third match. They came into the game having suffered a loss to England by 2 goals. And they certainly put that to rest. And that is beautiful work from McCloumack, just jumping the shot.
Yes, just perhaps a little casual on the shot. Didn't take into account the arms.
We said on Wednesday night that it was an incredible turnaround by the England side. Well, it is equally as impressive from the Silver Ferns side, who haven't let up at all throughout the entire match.
No, very much like their performance in the first test. Good team effort.
Can anything go right for England? Casey Williams certainly has had a lot to do with this comprehensive win by the Silver Ferns. Griffin, it'll be the final act for the Silver Ferns, and it's an air ball. So, the Silver Ferns have thumped England in the third test decider here at Arena Manawatū, 61 goals to 22. Ferns literally blowing the visitors off the court in the second quarter, scoring 22 goals to England's 2. It is, and it has been, an absolutely comprehensive win by the home side. Now it just goes to show Julie what wounded pride can do for players.
Well, that's right. We saw the turnaround, didn't we, after the first test when England were feeling so sick about their performance in that first test. And tonight, the Silver Ferns coming out feeling equally ill about their performance in the second test. And look at the delight on the faces of the players.
Well, the first match, it was 39 goals. The third match, it is again 39 goals.
Ruth Aitken, congratulations. Is it hard to believe you actually lost to this team on Wednesday?
Oh, yeah. It's been a very up and down week, obviously. But, you know, when we really went out there as a team today, on Wednesday we played as individuals, and you just can't do that. So I was very proud of it.
What do you think the difference was?
Yeah, I just think we were really committed to our team attack and defence. I thought the relentless pressure on right through court made it such a difference for us.
How did you feel, Irene van Dijk, under the post? Did you think that worked better than perhaps having her at a goal attack?
Oh, look, I think she's an amazing athlete at both positions. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. She's still growing in that role. Tonight was a good one.
Confident now heading into the Australian series. You've got a week to turn around. What will you be looking to do for that?
Yeah, well, we're home for all of 3 or 4 days and then back in over in Oz. We'll just be looking at fine-tuning, and they've got to recover well.
OK, all the best for the series.
Thank you. Cheers.
Well, Sue, you'll have great hair by the end of this tour. What do you put the fluctuations in form down to?
I just think that we let ourselves down from the word go. Our passing wasn't directed. We passed it into the Silver Ferns' hands quite a lot. You know, there's all those basic things. We stepped, we went offside. all those little things. So we didn't learn from our Wednesday night experience, and you know we should have built on it. And they're disappointed, and we'll go back, dissect it again, and next time we'll come up with a better game plan.
How much of it is to do with the Silver Ferns backlash since they were so hammered by the media?
Oh, well, you know, the media do a lot, but you know, we've got to look at our game. Silver Ferns certainly came out hungrier tonight. I don't think they were complacent on Wednesday night. I think we were the better team on the night. So, you know, all credit to the Ferns tonight, and we'll go back and work again.
Yeah, look, good luck with that, and we hope to see some stuff from you later on.
Absolutely.
Yes, an emphatic win for the Silver Ferns here in Palmerston North. Stay with us after the break. We have this.
Thanks for watching tonight's match. See you at the next one.
The scoreline here, the Silver Ferns over England. We're about to get underway with the presentation here in Palmerston North.
Welcome to the official presentation of the 2008 New World International Netball Series, England and the Silver Ferns. Please welcome the Chief Executive of Foodstuff South Island, Steve Anderson.
Thank you to the folk of Palmerston North for coming out in such great numbers to welcome the Silver Ferns and England teams tonight. When New World says they love netball as much as you do, it's very much with supporters like you in mind. This series has been a nail-biter from the beginning, and New World couldn't be more proud of the way in which our Silver Ferns have set the benchmark for gutsy determination in a sport that increasingly is capturing our nation. Your inspiration, not only to us at New World, but to every enthusiast who plays in the social team through to kids who want to follow in your footsteps is significant. At Foodstuffs, we're committed to supporting New Zealand netball at every level, from up-and-coming champions to the armies of volunteers at schools and clubs around the country. Also to this event, where the finest players in the world have demonstrated their skills and passion. New World's been part of your community for 45 years now, with 132 100% locally owned and operated stores, from Kerikeri in the north to Ellis Road in Invercargill. We want to make sure that we give everyone in our communities the backing in the future to participate in netball at whatever level they choose. And we hope over the coming years to reflect the passion and loyalty that has made netball such a part of the fabric of Kiwi culture. Well done again to both teams for keeping us on the edge of our seats. And thanks to New Zealand for keeping the faith, getting in behind netball and loving netball as much as we do.
And now please welcome the Chief Executive of Netball New Zealand, Raylene Castle.
Thank you, Hemi. This has been a wonderful season of international netball, and this New World International Netball Series between the Silver Ferns and England is no exception. Thank you to both teams for making the series such an exciting contest from start to finish. Our congratulations to England, especially on your great result in Dunedin on Wednesday. We really appreciate everything you've done during this series. Special congratulations to the Silver Ferns on tonight's outstanding win and winning the New World International Netball Series. And another step back to our top spot at number one. Thank you to New World, the elite sponsor of the Silver Ferns. We appreciate you everything you do for international netball and also everything you do right into the community. Also our family of sponsors, Fisher & Paykel, Holden, Asics, TVNZ, Radio Sport and to Spark. Thank you to the umpires for this series, Rachel Eyre, Jackie Jassari and Sharon Kelly. And to all of Netball's regional administrators and officials in the places we've taken these tests to, without your help we wouldn't be able to put on such a great event. Netball New Zealand is delighted tonight to present a new trophy, the Tiny Jamieson Trophy. Tiny Jamieson is one of the great contributors to our sport. With 60 years of service to Bay of Plenty and New Zealand netball, and she also was the coach of the first World Championship winning Silver Fern team. This trophy will be won by all teams not playing international netball, and it gives me great pleasure to ask Tiny herself to come forward and present the trophy for the first time to the Silver Ferns captain, Julie Seymour.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. After initially being disappointed that I couldn't play because of injury, I think you'll agree it makes it so enjoyable to sit back and watch the Silver Ferns play so superbly. So well done. I just want to start by thanking England for Sue and Sonia and your team for the series. I'm sure you enjoy playing international netball as much as we do. Particularly the lessons that we learned from Wednesday night, I think you showed all sports people a lesson in pride and coming back from a disappointment and, you know, rising above things. So thank you very much for that lesson. I know lots of people have learned lots. We wish you well in your future netball, and we look forward to the next time that we play you again. My girls, in particular after Wednesday, I know we did a lot of soul searching. It was a great lesson for us, individually, as a team, as a management, as coaches. We really had a hard look at ourselves and what we could improve on and what we could do better. And I'm so very proud of the way you all came out tonight and played. Well done. I do want to pay particular attention to one of our players, our wonderful Irene, who on her 90th game for New Zealand made 100%.
Yes, a very happy Irene van Dyke there. But now we can announce for you the player of the series, and that's across the five tests, two against Australia and three against England, and it is Laura Langmuir. You're seeing here just on the left of the screen, she is our player of the series, so congratulations to Laura. Fantastic effort. She was consistent right throughout the series. Stay with us after the break. We'll have a lot more reaction here from Palmerston North.
Came along, extreme ways I know will part
see. Perfect colour me. Extreme waves that held me.
Back to Manawatu Arena, where the Silver Ferns have beaten England 61-22. That's given them the win for the series. It wasn't the clean sweep they were after, but tonight's convincing win would have surely put a smile on their face, Kerry.
Yeah, look, they walked the talk, didn't they? They said earlier in the week they were adamant that it wasn't Ruth Aitken's responsibility out there on court. The players have got to put it out there. And all seven and the subs that came on, they did a really good job. It was commanding, it was convincing, and it makes us feel good about this upcoming series.
Absolutely. And I guess when you look at England, they talked themselves up a bit after that Wednesday match, and now they'll be hurting like the Ferns were on Wednesday.
Yeah, look, they'll be sending poor Sue Hawkins to an early grave. They're sublime one day and then awful the next, and vice versa. We need them, they'll need to step up and find that consistency.
Absolutely. And the Silver Ferns are heading to Australia. We will be here One Sport exclusively live 5 p.m. and on TV2 this time. So it's not TV1, TV2. Make sure you switch across channels to join us. Two matches across the Tasman, Melbourne and in Brisbane. Well, thank you so much for joining us here. It's been a fantastic series. The Silver Ferns have given us a few heart attacks at times, but they have cleaned up here tonight. If you'd like to have a look at anything more from tonight's coverage, go to our website, www.tvnz.co.nz. You can look at all the replays, look at the game again, and we will see you across the Tasman in Australia.
Sing about angels like Angel I rock, and Fame Alive rock, and Sam Adai rock, and Emma Dye and Tamara, me Najee Moi. I'm in here like, bitch, what's up? Mechanic me, I can fix you up, I can dick you up, I can dick you down. Shout it, we could go wherever, just pick a town. And my jewelry is louder than an engine sound. Big ass rocks like on the ground. Dirty like socks that's on the ground. We say, because when I arrive, I'll bring the fire, make you come alive. I can take you higher with this.
Coverage of tonight's match was proudly brought to you by New World. We love netball as much as you do.